Beautiful afternoon on the LMU campus and here at the LMU Soccer Complex as the Lincoln Memorial University Railsplitter men's soccer team prepares to play host to the Eagles of Carson-Newman College, in-state and South Atlantic Conference rival. Hello and good afternoon, everybody. I'm Rusty Peace. Glad to have you with us this afternoon. The Lincoln Memorial University men's soccer team comes into today's match at 4-4-1 on the year, 2-2-1 in South Atlantic Conference play. Their most recent win last Saturday, and that was over Brevard College on the road over in Brevard, North Carolina. For the Eagles of Carson-Newman, they're 5-3 on the year, 2-2 in league action, and they have battled with LMU over the last several years to the point where Lincoln Memorial has taken four out of the last six meetings, including last year's match in overtime, 1-0. That was on November 2nd of 2012. Before that, Carson-Newman won on the September 19th. And then LMU won the previous two meetings on November 1st, 2011, and September 28th, 2011. Carson-Newman winning on September 29th of 2010. LMU won back in 09. It's going to be an interesting matchup today. Anytime these two teams square off, obviously it's a very physical match, a lot of fouls, many times a lot of cards. The Railsplitters return to the LMU Soccer Complex after a two-match South Atlantic Conference road swing. LMU opened that two-game trip by suffering a 2-1 loss at Lenoir Ryan before rebounding with a 1-0 victory over Brevard last Saturday. Defender Nathaniel Johnson scored in the 86th minute of Saturday's win to pace the Railsplitters. Today's match features a rematch of the semifinal game from 2012's Food Lion South Atlantic Conference Championship. In that match, Diego Deschamps scored in the 99th minute to give the Railsplitters a 1-0 triumph. Carson-Newman comes into today riding a strong stretch of play on the pitch as they have won three of their last four matches. Most recently, the Eagles toppled Lenoir Ryan 3-0 in Jefferson City this past weekend. Earlier in the week, we had the opportunity to sit down with Heli O'Dana and talk to him about today's match with Carson-Newman, and here's what he had to say.
And I'll be honest with you, they're not they play with fairness and sportsmanship. They're not a dirty team by all means, but it is physical. It's the nature of the way they play, and they are very direct, very well coached on flicks and like cross switches and long balls, in which we got to read the first ball, but we got to read the second ball. You know, that's how they've been hurting people, is when you challenge that first ball in the air, but then you don't follow the runs that come off of that ball, you know, because sometimes their player might not win the first ball, but it will get redirected, and they do a great job finding where the ball is going next, if that makes sense. So that's tricky, you know, you got to stay on the whole time. The 1 second you fall asleep is the second that they pick up a scrappy goal, but they're solid everywhere. I consider them the best team in the conference. Not judging by results, because soccer makes no sense. I'm judging by their quality. They're the best team in the conference, and I don't have a problem saying that. So we'll have to be pretty solid from beginning to end.
Well, today's match equally as important for both Lincoln Memorial and Carson-Newman. If you look at the South Atlantic Conference standings, both teams are just around the middle of the pack, actually toward the back half or two-thirds a bit. LMU right there in about the 6 or 7 spot at 2-2-1, 4-4-1 overall. Carson-Newman right behind them at 2-2, 5-3 in league action. So it is, when you get into October, I mean, you've got to win these matches, and I love that saying that Josh Schertz has about the early season. You can't win the conference regular season race or put yourself in the region tournament early in the year, but you can sure play your way out of it. Both of these teams are trying to keep those hopes alive for the NCAA regional play. It's a long shot for everybody because a lot of teams in the region do have losses, but here in the South Atlantic Conference, everybody with the exception of Queens has at least one or two losses on the year. So it's going to be interesting over this next few weeks to see what happens. And for Lincoln Memorial here today, it'll be their last home match until they play host to non-conference opponent, Trevecca Nazarene, on the 17th. That'll be at a 3:30 start here at the LMU Soccer Complex. Let's run down your starting lineup. First of all, for the Eagles today, they're under the direction of head coach Richard Moody. And I beg your pardon on some of these pronunciations. Rumwald Legevel will start in the net, a 6'1 senior goalkeeper out of Venice, France. At the defender position, Christopher Trillo, 5'8 and a senior from Guatemala City, Guatemala. Duncan Foster will start at midfield, 6 foot and a junior from the United Kingdom. Wade Collins at midfield, 5'7, a junior out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Kristen Speak will start at defensive mid, 5'10, and a junior from Pembrokeshire, United Kingdom. Sendre Welo will start at midfield, 6'2, and a sophomore out of Norway. And Mateus Bachi will start at defender, 6'4, senior from Brazil. Jake Fielder at midfield, 6 foot, a junior from Talbot, Tennessee. Joshin Nikolai Knoll at midfield forward, a 6'1 junior from Germany. Ross Frame will start at forward, 5'11 and a junior from the United Kingdom. And then at defensive mid, a 5'10 sophomore out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Rurik Pereira. Again, the Eagles come into today's match 5-3, 2-2 in league action. For the Railsplitters today, Marcel Barvenitz will start in the net, 6'1, a junior from Berlin, Germany. Callum Holm will be at defender, 6 foot, a senior out of East Kilbride, Scotland. Yuri Passos plays at the midfield position, 5'9, a junior from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. At forward, Leonardo da Silva, 5'10, a redshirt sophomore out of Brazil. George Byrne starts at forward, 6'2, a freshman from Carlisle, England. Mario Pinto at the midfield forward position, 5'11, a senior from Uberlandia, Brazil. Harry Solomon starts at defender and at forward, 5'8, a freshman from Leicester, England. It is Nathaniel Johnson, the defensive mid, 6 foot sophomore out of London, England. Pedro Villa will start at midfield forward, 5'9, a sophomore from New Braunfels, Texas. Gus Rivera starting at defensive mid, 5'8, a junior from Maryville, Tennessee. And Keegan Sanders making the start today, a 5'11 freshman from Kennesaw, Georgia. Railsplitters under the direction of head coach Elio Dana. Again, entering today's match 4-4-1 overall, 2-2-1 in South Atlantic Conference play. Looking at the SAC standings, let's go through how they stack up. Queens comes into this Saturday's meeting, at least for today, undefeated at 5-0. They're 8-1 overall. Anderson University at 3-2 in the 2 spot. They're 7-2-1 overall. Wingate University also tied for that 2 spot, 3-2, 6-3. Mars Hill still clinging to a 3-2-1 record. They're 3-5 overall. Catawba College, 2-2-1, 5-2-1. Coker, 2-2-1, 4-3-2. Lincoln Memorial University, 2-2-1, 4-4-1 rather. Carson-Newman clinging to a 2-2 conference record, 5-3 overall. Lenore Ryan at 2-2, 6-4. Newberry, 1-3-1, 1-8-1. And then, of course, Tusculum 1-3, 3-5. Brevard in the cellar at 0-4. The only team in the league with no victory yet in conference play. They're 2-7 overall. So it has been a league that has absolutely beat up on each other. One that, you know, with no automatic bid to the NCAA tournament, could quite possibly have knocked each and every one of those teams out of the NCAA regional. So really the only team that might have a sure lock right now, it would be Queens at 5-0 if they can run the table and finish the regular season unbeaten, but even that's not certain. We've got a great match of soccer in store for you. It's Lincoln Memorial, Carson Newman. I guarantee you it's going to be sparks flying. There's going to be a lot of physical play, and hopefully it's going to be a high-octane offense-type afternoon. We hope that you'll stay with us as we'll take this break, and we'll be back with today's opening touch through Sigma Communications. This is the LMU Sports Network.
Looking for efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family? Visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available, including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine, with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic.
It's the Old Town Grill. The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family. more than friends.
Bring a hearty appetite, because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
No matter whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interests at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwich or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner time, choose from our wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches, all made to your order. If you're serving a crowd, Subway has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Whether it's dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. Subway, 362 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Since 1973, DeRoyal has been a leader and an innovator in manufacturing products for the healthcare industry. DeRoyal supplies more than 20,000 products and product lines such as acute care, orthopedics, wound care, and trauma. DeRoyal is proud to be the largest supplier of orthopedic soft goods to clinics and hospitals in the nation. Since its start in Tazewell, Tennessee, DeRoyal has grown to open factories in over 29 locations worldwide and employs over 2,000 people. DeRoyal, a name you can trust and an employer you can count on.
The J. Frank White Academy is more than a high school. Your child will have room to grow in mind, body, and spirit. Small, safe learning environments, individualized learning plans, and cutting-edge technology. Every child deserves a quality education in a safe, nurturing environment.
Our college prep program teaches a love of learning, self-discipline, and service to others. The Academy is fully accredited by Advanced Ed. You have a choice at the J. Frank White Academy.
When you're traveling throughout the tri-states, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express of Middlesbrough. With nearly 60 rooms to choose from, fitness center, full complimentary hot breakfast bar, and seasonal pool, Holiday Inn Express of Middlesbrough is all about catering to your travel needs. Our rooms are all equipped with flat-screen TV, refrigerator, microwave, and we're conveniently located just seconds from the area's attractions. When you're on the road, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express, located on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesbrough. Make reservations today by calling 606-248-6860.
Farm Bureau Insurance, you can manage your auto, home, and life policies any way you want. If you like the internet, get a quote and file claims online at FBITN.com. If you like to take care of your business over the phone, give us a call. If you like to email, send us a message and we'll take care of you that way. But if you like an old-fashioned smile and handshake at the door, come down to the local office.
Juggling my family's schedule is a full-time job. Between school, dance practice, work, there's little time left to worry about much else. That's why I use real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. With real-time banking, I know that when I make a deposit, the money goes straight to my account. No delays, no waiting, no wondering. And I get to focus on what's important.
Real-time deposits, real-time access, real-time banking. From Home Federal Bank, always within reach.
For great food, fun, and entertainment, visit the Oasis on Highway 25E in Harrogate, Tennessee, with a new drive-thru to better serve you. At the Oasis, you can enjoy a great lunch buffet or order from the great menu that the tri-state area has grown to love. Pizza, salad bar, and a tasty sandwich from the deli. And don't forget your favorite beverages. Check out the live music each week at the Oasis, where regional and local bands strut their stuff to a packed house. Or stop by and catch the big race on the big screen. All roads lead to the Oasis. 6341 Cumberland Gap Parkway in Harrogate, Tennessee. Phone in your order, 423-869-8000.
Whether traveling for business or pleasure, Sleep Inn & Suites of Middlesbrough, Kentucky invites you to dream better here. Located at the foothills of the Cumberland Gap, Sleep Inn & Suites offers luxurious rooms equipped with microwave fridge combo, desk, ergonomic chair, wireless internet, and 32-inch flat-screen TV. While staying with us, visit our fitness center, wake up to our complimentary hot breakfast bar, or have a bedtime snack with our fresh-baked cookies. Sleep Inn & Suites, located off Highway 25E, Middlesbrough.
Make K&K Metal Sales your only stop for all your residential and commercial metal building needs. For the past 23 years, K&K Metal Sales has covered the tri-state area with quality custom roofing and siding with many grades, gauges, and colors in stock. If you're looking for complete steel or wood building packages or steel or wood trusses, K&K Metal Sales can help with that, as well as heavy-duty custom carports. Great folks and great prices. Stop by K&K Metal Sales located at 6986 Cumberland Gap Parkway or call 423-869-4261.
I've been a hard worker all my life. It's just the way I was raised. I work the third shift. While most people are wrapping up their day, I'm just getting started. If I make a deposit on Friday night, I can't wait for it to go through the next week. Home Federal Bank's real-time banking is different. Real-time banking takes the worry out of banking. Lets me think about what's important.
Real-time deposits, real-time access. Real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. Always within reach.
Today's broadcast of Lincoln Memorial University Soccer is brought to you by University Medical Clinic, with two locations to serve you in Harrogate and New Tazewell, Tennessee. University Medical Clinic. By Farm Bureau Insurance. By Old Town Grill. By Home Federal Bank of Harrogate. Always within reach, Home Federal Bank. By Subway of Harrogate and Middlesboro. Eat fresh at Subway. By Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro. Sleep smart at Holiday Inn Express. By Oasis Pizza and Substation. By DeRoyal, a name you can trust, a product you can count on. DeRoyal. By K&K Metal Sales. By Sleep Inn of Middlesboro. Dream better here at Sleep Inn. By the J. Frank White Academy. And by Lincoln Memorial University. Your career path is here.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite, because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
Welcome back to the LMU Soccer Complex. Your crew for today's broadcast: Adam Haley on your technical direction, Matt Rushing on camera, as well as Tony Spinosa will be joined later by Adam Plyler. This is a production of Sigmund Communications. Your executive producer for the broadcast is Tony Spinosa, pulling double duties today. And this is all part of the LMU Sports Network. Rusty Peace here with you for your call of Lincoln Memorial University soccer as the Railsplitters try to do what the Lady Railsplitters were not able to do today. LMU's women losing 3-2 in overtime to Carson-Newman. And Lincoln Memorial trying to back this past Saturday's win over Brevard College in league play with a victory here this afternoon over the Eagles of Carson-Newman. Carson-Newman has the utmost respect from LMU head coach Helly O'Dana. He believes, quite frankly, that they are the best team in the league. They have a lot of talent. They have a lot of ability, and he respects what they're capable of. So he knows that this is going to be a hard match today regardless. And we've seen a lot of matches this year in league play. LMU has not been blown out of any of them, so I can guarantee that this is going to be a tight match regardless. But without a doubt, the Railsplitters have had more than their fair share of overtime matches, four overtime matches this year, and Lincoln Memorial winless in those four. They did manage a tie against Coker University. Railsplitters will have the opening touch here to open the afternoon's play, and we are underway in Harrogate. LMU in the home white tops, defending the goal to your right. Carson-Newman in the visiting navy tops, trimmed in orange and white, and they'll defend the goal to the left. Eagles in their backfield. This is Trejo. Ball played to the near side. And that is Pereira who plays it back to the keeper. Ball way off the far sideline. Throw in for Lincoln Memorial. Just underway here in Harrogate, and anytime these two teams square off, there's always a lot of fireworks, a lot of physical play. This is Johnson, Nathaniel Johnson, the sophomore, scoring the game-winning goal against Brevard on Saturday. Johnson looking over his options, plays it across the field to teammate Callum Holmes. Home up the far sideline. Pass intended for Byrne. Byrne retains possession. Plays it off the Carson-Newman defender, I believe last touched by Knoll, and that'll be a throw-in for Lincoln Memorial in front of their own dugout. Comes into Johnson. Johnson looking across the field, and he's got Sanders. Sanders plays it outside to Solomon. Solomon's again off the Carson-Newman defender, kept in play by Da Silva. And now this is Passos going far sideline, intended for home. Long ball down to the corner. Mario Pinto racing to get there, and the keeper shields him off of it as he lets it roll out of play. And so Carson-Newman will have the goal kick. Romuald Leguevel, a 6'1 senior, listed at only 6'1, looks taller than that on the field. He's out of Venice, France. Only time these two teams will meet in regular season play. The last meeting, LMU came away with a 1-0 victory in overtime. And again, that was on November 2nd of 2012. Challenge at midfield won by the Railsplitters. Villa trying to get to it, couldn't get there in time. Carson-Newman gets possession, and this is Trejo. I beg your pardon, that was Speak, who played it back to Foster. Coach Dana feeling that Carson-Newman is very direct. So far, they've done a pretty good job of playing possession. They've got a Brazilian flavor on the team, very much as Coach Dana does, but a large contingency of European players as well. Sun really beaming down here this afternoon in Harrogate. A lot of fans with their umbrellas out trying to get some shade. Shade is a rare commodity here in the LMU bleacher section, without a doubt. Lincoln Memorial getting possession back there as Marvin Eats sends it far side over to home. Out it goes to Gus Rivera, now back to home. Railsplitters look like they're just trying to get their shape. Ball played across midfield. Byrne trying to get there, but a nice play by the Carson-Newman defender to step up on it. This is Frame. Plays it far sideline. Frame with a hard tackle by home. Ball into the box. Nice kick save by Barbanitz. Great reflexes by the goalkeeper. Barbanitz only a junior. Pinto keeps it in play. Villa has to come back on it. Ball checked back. Header toward the midfield line. Stepping up on it is LMU's Solomons. And he'll give it over to Passos. Passos gets it away. Byrne with a flick. Trying to get Pinto on the run. Cleared out by Carson-Newman. And that'll be an LMU throw-in near side of the field. The skill level of these two teams is just unbelievable. I mean, when you watch a women's game and you see the skill level they have, and then all of a sudden you go to the men's matchup and see how much greater it is. It's just incredible. Here's Sanders midfield, plays it back to home. Home's got plenty of time. Showing a bit of urgency to get to it, rightly so. Almost 5 minutes into this one. Long ball near side of the field to Villa. He has time to pull it in, bring it down, and turn. Gives it over to De Silva and an offside call on Lincoln Memorial. That was either Pinto or Byrne. One of the two was off. I could hear the shouting in the background as they were trying to tell the LMU forwards. Carson-Newman on the run. Speak taking it to the far side of the field. Stood up by the LMU defender, Passos. And now Pinto will pressure the defender in the backfield. Plays it back over to Guevel. Switches the field near side to Pereira. Back to the keeper. Romuald Leguevel. Long ball up the far sideline. And that ball out of play. That'll be Lincoln Memorial possession on the throw-in. Soccer is such a fickle sport. I mean, you can outshoot a team, as LMU did in the opening match, yet still lose it. LMU out shooting and having more shots on goal. Foul called on the Railsplitters as that ball will go to Carson-Newman. At midfield, this is Frame. Plays it back to his teammate. And now the ball sent up to Speak. Pereira will take over near midfield. Plays the ball far side, just off the outstretched leg of Mario Pinto, right to his teammate. Cross to the box. Well past both posts, headed back toward the box. Johnson heads it out. Shot taken wide right by Christian Speak, and that'll be a goal kick for Lincoln Memorial. Carson Newman has pressured LMU early. Marvin Eats already with a save as he used the foot to kick it out. Very quick reflexes on that save by Marcel Barbanitz. Long pause by the junior goalkeeper. Good kick to the midfield line. Passos going up for the challenge. Won by Carson Newman. Second ball also taken by the Eagles. And played up the field. Scrambling to get there is Harry Solomons, and he'll let it roll out of play along with Barbanitz. And that'll be another goal kick for Lincoln Memorial. Practical purposes just underway here in Harrogate, 37-30 remaining in the first half. LMU's Mario Pinto, top scorer in the league a year ago. LMU going all the way to the SAC championship before being eliminated from the tournament. Eagles taking it upfield. Johnson challenging. Holm clears it. Good job by LMU's Leonardo da Silva to contest that pass. Ball out in front of the goal, cleared by Callum Holm. And is he going to? Well, I'm not sure what the whistle was about. There may have been an offside call. Again, it's from my vantage point, even here in the press box, it's tough to see both ends of the field. And the line judge down at that end of the field is out of my field of view. Apparently, it was in fact an offside call, and so Barbanitz will kick it away. Excellent ball down the field, taken down by Carson Newman's Trejo. And the Eagles send it back equally the opposite way. Ball went out of play, and so Barvin eats with another goal kick. Richard Moody has paced the sidelines over there for better than a match and a quarter now. Ball knocked out of play. That's going to be LMU possession, as it was apparently last touched by the Eagles, and Moody not happy with the call. Inbound to Byrne. Sends it down line with the left leg, and that's out of play back to Carson Newman. Tell you what, just as cold as it's been here at nights here in the last few nights down in the mid to lower 40s, and then all of a sudden you come in here today and temperatures in the 80s, it's just blistering hot out here. There's Rivera, sends it far sideline. Villa plays it off the Carson Newman defender and a throw-in for Lincoln Memorial. Rivera will have the throw-in. Played back to Passos. That ball still in play. I'm not sure what Passos was thinking. He just kind of stood there with the defender in his face, and the defender took it away from him. Over to the near side. Here's Foster. Plays the ball toward the middle. Holm tried to play it, missed it. Nice header that time by Carson Image, Jake Fielder, but Holm took it away from him. Eagles get it back. Barvin Eats will come out on it. No pressure on him, so he can keep it down there on the feet. Plays the ball near side of the field over to Solomons. Solomon's carrying that space across midfield. Great ball for Pinto, but again, Pinto offsides. He's got to be more aware of where he is in relation to the final defender. I don't think the defender stepped up that time. I think he was just offside to start with. He's got tremendous speed. If he'll just step back a little bit, I think he could probably outrun most defenders. Eagles on the offensive, although in their own half of the field. Wibble way out of the box. Solomon steals it, sends it upfield, taking it in for Carson Evans, Pereira. Ball being kicked around at midfield. Speak with possession. Now back to the far side of the pitch. Looks like that's Ross Frame back there. Played by Speak. Over to the near side again. This is Pereira. And Solomons takes it away. Pinto checks back to Johnson. Johnson double team. Getting pressure from behind. Plays it toward the middle of the field. Sanders getting pressure from two Eagles. Plays it back to Rivera. And Rivera will give it to home to square things up. Now Passos will turn. Sends it across the midfield line. Pass intended for Pinto, but he's nowhere near it. Not his fault. Pass just wasn't near the feet. Long ball toward the box. Solomons gets to it. Shields the defender. Plays it out. And I'm not sure that's going to be a throw-in. I don't think it was off the end line. So for Carson Newman, it'll be Duncan Foster that steps back there. Foster, 6 foot junior out of the United Kingdom. Throw toward the box. Johnson with a check from behind. Solomon sends it upfield. Byrne, great header right into LMU's Leonardo da Silva. LMU wanting a handball right there. Eagles tactically trying to position themselves. Speak. Shaking a couple of LMU defenders. Plays it back to Pereira at midfield. Long ball far side. Nice header toward the box. And Barbanitz will go over and gobble it up. Keeps it around the feet. That'll allow LMU to just take it out at their own pace. Here's home under a little pressure. Sends it up the far sideline. Villa was the intended player. Sanders challenging the ball there at midfield. We thought we might have a foul call, but nothing there. Barbanitz out off the frame again. Way out of the box there. And LMU looked like Sanders went down over there. Might have taken a shot to the midsection. Hard to really tell exactly what took place. Nonetheless, a Carson Newman foul. Passos up to Da Silva. Now drops back to Johnson. Johnson trying to get one to Pereira. Eagles kick it out of play. That's Duncan Foster that touched it last. So a throw in by Solomons, and he'll drop back to Johnson. Johnson across the midline, receiving pressure. Plays it off the Carson Newman defender, and Solomons will get it back for LMU. Over to home. He'll switch the field now. Takes it far side. Dumps it off to Sanders. Sanders over to Rivera. Rivera trying to pull it in after that first touch. Carson Newman taking it away from Rivera. And now it's Frame that runs it down the midfield. Nice tackle by Lincoln Memorial's Callum Home. Cross in front of the box, cleared out by Johnson, and a throw in by the Eagles near side. Great play by the all-conference performer Callum Home to come in and deny a shot in the box with a sliding tackle. Speak crosses towards the left corner of the box, headed back in. Johnson trying to stand the defender up. He tries to make his turn, cleared out by Passos. And now Villa will run the far sideline. LMU with possession and on the run. Villa taking up some real estate. Ball kicked towards the Carson Newman box, and Villa will run it down. Pushed off the ball a bit, gets it back. Villa crosses it to Byrne. Byrne takes one touch, battles. The big freshman knocked to the ground. And a foul on the Eagles as he was sandwiched between Duncan Foster and also Rurik Pereira. So Byrne's going to get ahead in the box over there, and Eli O'Dana wants Yuri Passos to step over there for Lincoln Memorial and try to get something over there that they can get a footer ahead on. 29-14 to play in the first half. We're scoreless. LMU's had one shot. Actually, Carson Newman's had one shot on goal. Here's Passos. Bends one toward the frame, right at the keeper, punched out with a fist. Ripped right at the keeper again. Great shot by Harry Solomons from the defensive backfield, and the keeper really having to earn his money on that those two exchanges. So two shots on goal back-to-back by Lincoln Memorial. At midfield, this is Frame. Drops back, now played over to the near side. Foster takes over. He's got a lot of room. Dumps it off up the field to Speak. Speak goes over to the corner. trying to square up his fielder. Fielder sends across to the top of the box. Headed inside, Johnson whiffs it, and that'll go out of play for a corner kick as he tried to clear it out, and it came off the wrong side and went out of the inline. So a corner kick for the Eagles. Railsplitter's trying to get in defensive position. Cross into the box. Helm heads it out. Villa, long punch up the field. Foot race. Great ball for Pinto. Pinto got two guys to beat in the keeper. Makes his move at the left elbow. Pushed off the ball a bit, heading for the corner. And he's pushed out of play. That'll be Lincoln Memorial throw-in. The Railsplitters now pushing up the field so they can try to lock this in. Harry Solomon's trotting over to the corner. He'll have the throw-in. Just a great ball that was sent up here on the near sideline to Pinto. Solomon's cross in the box. Coming up on it was Sanders. Couldn't get there. Header towards Pinto. He brings it in, turns and fires. It's going to go wide right. And a goal kick for the Eagles. Pinto had the right idea, and he hit the right gap to go toward the goal, but unfortunately just too far wide right. Didn't have a whole lot on it either. Scoreless at the near midway point of the first half. In the defensive backfield for Carson-Newman, this is Pereira. Sends it up to the midfield. Home checks it. Passos gets it back to Johnson. Johnson clearing it out off the sideline. Throw in for the Eagles. Throw-in will come from Foster. Headed back by Passos, and then again out of play off of Lincoln Memorial. To the best of my knowledge, neither team has had a substitution yet. We've played about 19 minutes. Throw-in. Sanders standing up the offensive player. Pinto takes it away, crosses the field to Villa. And Villa looks upfield for some room. Over to Byrne, right at dead center field. Up to Pinto. Keeper coming out on it. He was pressured heavily by Pinto. High ball. Passos trying to get there. Good job of the Carson-Newman defender to shield him. And Passos is going to be called for the foul, saying that that is dangerous play. The Eagles will take it over on the LMU half of the field. Rurik Pereira will step up on the ball. LMU awaiting the delivery. The official still trying to hold play up here to get it going. Off of Byrne, headed away by Solomons. And Pinto hits it upfield toward Byrne. Whiffed by the defender, Pereira. Here's Pereira. Crosses over on Solomons. Chips one toward the box. Johnson punches it away. Pereira gets it back. Knocked away by Passos again. And a foul on Lincoln Memorial's Passos as Christian Speak went to the ground, and that'll be Carson-Newman ball about 30 yards out, maybe 32, top of the box. And now the official stopping play momentarily as he marks off 10 yards for the LMU wall. A lot of jawing going on out there. That's usually the case with these two teams. Undecided yet. There's a shot toward the box. Barvanich punches it up, and that'll go out of play for a goal kick in Carson-Newman. So a save for Barvanich right there. Used both fists to punch that one out. High ball toward the crossbar. Corner kick will come from the near corner, way past the far post. Still kept alive in the box. Header off around the left side. That was by Carson Newman's Duncan Foster, and it'll go out of play, so a goal kick for Lincoln Memorial. Carson Newman is such a big team in terms of their physical height. Yeah, they got a lot of guys in the box who can elevate and get ahead on it. And it's just a matter of a well-placed ball. We know how dangerous that is. 23-10 remaining in the half. Marvin Eats punches it up across the midline. Nice header by Byrne. I don't think Pinto really thought that he was going to get that much of it. Keeper sends it toward midfield, hit back by Sanders. And Carson Newman will win the second ball. Ball up the near sideline. Fielder to pull it in. He's checked defensively by Solomons. Solomons pushes him off the ball and takes it away. Checked back over towards Passos. And a foul on Carson Newman. As looked like Wade Collins made the contact on Yuri Passos, and official wasn't having any of it. Solomon, long ball across the middle of the field. Villa will have it to himself in the corner if he can get there. Now, he will not be able to. Not going to try as that ball will ride out off the end line, and there'll be a corner kick. Wise decision by Villa. And that'll allow Sanders to go over there and take the corner. And LMU trying to get in the box. Railsplitters with two shots on goal. Carson Newman with two shots on goal here in the first half. And we're less than 25 minutes in. Crossing the box. Hit by Villa. Home gets it. It's right on the line. Home crosses. I think the keeper got it before it went across. There was a defender and the keeper there. The defender did not make hand contact with it. The keeper was actually laying down, reached back, and stopped it from going over the line. Unbelievable. Near side of the field, Foster taking up some real estate. Sends a deep ball. Coming out on it is Barvanites. He catches it on the fly, and he'll let some pressure go by. Real splitters pushing up the field now as Barvanites will kick it away. Rivera, far side of the field, plays it over to home. Now to Passos, under pressure, drops back to Johnson. Over to home again. And up to Sanders. Here's Rivera, far sideline. Switches the field. Johnson will bring it down on the bounce. Up to Da Silva. Cross midfield, pass intended for Solomons, headed back across midfield by Carson Newman. Now the Eagles on a run. Home overplayed it. Shot on its way in the right corner. That's Carson Newman's Josh and Nikolai Knoll, the 6'1 junior from Germany. And the Eagles go up 1-0. A bad misjudgment on the Railsplitters' part right there. There was a long ball up the field. Callum Holm did everything he could to play it. Unfortunately, it hopped over his head. And Josh and Nikolai Knoll caught it on the bounce, punched it in the back right corner. Despite Marcel Barvanites laying out, sacrificing the body, trying to stop it. Eagles take a 1-0 lead. 20-15 to play in the first half. Sooner or later, for one of the two teams, the way things were happening, you knew it was going to go. This is Speak to the far side of the field. Dumps it off in midfield. Eagles top of the shot, top of the box shot. Deflected wide left out of play, and that'll be a corner kick, apparently off one of the rail splitters, possibly Harry Solomons. Ross Frame taking the shot, and now the corner for Carson Newman from the far side. Been a tough day for LMU soccer. Lady Railsplitters fell in overtime, 3-2 to the Eagles after leading 2-1. Punched out again by Barvanites. Villa trying to get there. He'll get to the sideline, keeps it in play, got some running room. He'll take it across midfield. Looking for some support now. Drops back to Byrne at the stripe, taken away by Carson Newman. That was Fielder that took it away. Byrne still contesting. Fielder again, checks to the midline. Collins has it taken away. Byrne on the break. Railsplitters with some numbers here. Byrne pushes the defender off, checks it back. He's got it in the corner. Pinto's got to make sure he stays on side here. Cross toward the box area, nothing but blue jerseys. And coming down with it for Carson-Newman is Fielder. Sanders deflects it out of bounds, throw in for the Eagles near side of the field. LMU sub ready to check in. The Gwebel back there, the goalkeeper, just taking his time. Drops it over on the near sideline to Foster. Foster across the midline. Johnson knocks it back. De Silva pushed off the ball, and a foul on Carson-Newman. No intent there to play the ball, and the Railsplitters will regain possession. Johnson to Passos. Up to De Silva. Over to Solomons. Solomons making a run down the sideline against the double team. Splits it. Goes around it. Just have a shot. Solomons hits the defender. George Byrne trying to hit it in there. Nothing doing. Drop back to Sanders. Sanders looking far side of the field. He's got Rivera. Chip shot by Sanders. Header over the top of the crossbar by De Silva. And LMU getting some opportunities. So this match far from over as they tried to get that goal back. And now the substitution will take place for Lincoln Memorial. And it appears, though, it'll be Leonardo De Silva that comes out checking in for Lincoln Memorial. Is going to be Bryson Lynn. 5'8 freshman from Hendersonville, Tennessee, played at Good Pasture High School. Under the 17-minute mark. That's what we have remaining in the first half of play. Challenge at midfield. Carson-Newman wins it. Ball played over to Fielder, and he'll drop back to his teammate, Christian Speak. Now off to Foster. Backed off to the keeper. Plays it right down the middle. This is Collins. And over to the far side of the field. Matias Bocci. Header toward the middle of the field. Johnson, long ball down through there. Nothing but Carson-Newman jerseys. Herrera being pressured a little bit by Pinto. Plays near side to Foster. Up line and away to Fielder. Keeps it in play. Collins switches the field. Far side over to Bocci, or Bocci, depending on how you pronounce that. Up to Knoll. Knoll has the goal for the afternoon thus far for the Eagles. Cross into the box. Well off the mark. Foot race to it. Solomons trying to get there. Ball goes out of play. LMU throw in. Lynn will have the honor. Drops it to Pinto. Checks it back to Lynn. Now over to Johnson. Long ball down the middle again. Again, nothing but Carson-Newman jerseys. And again, the keeper comes out well outside the top of the box to give the Eagles their shape. Kind of a lull in the action right now. I mean, the keeper is a fourth of the way from the goal down the field. Really provides another player, and he's got such a great kick that he can get it down the field and pretty much to the box in one swing. Sanders battling for it. Solomons gets it, punches it up to Pinto. Now over to Passos. Ball for Pinto. Foot race, keeper way out of the box. Pinto going for it equally. Keeper clears it. And now Pinto, actually it'll be Lynn that has the throw in. Solomons drops back to Johnson. Up to Solomons. Solomons turns. Splits the defenders. Takes a third thrown to the ground and a foul on Carson-Newman, obstruction. Mario Pinto will step over there to it. Maybe Yuri Passos, actually. Pinto was just stopping the ball. 13:28 to go here in the first half. LMU and Carson-Newman, typical battle. 1-0 Eagles. Passos. Last time he had this situation, it was right at the keeper. Keeper really had to make an effort to get it out of there. Passos, again, punched out by the keeper. Unfortunately, Solomons with the left foot hit it a little bit wide right. Villa puts it back in the box. Header comes out from the Eagles and sent down the field by Carson-Newman. Barvanite's way out of the box as well, coming up to help his team. Rivera plays far side. That's Sanders. Passos off the foot, out of play. Carson-Newman possession on the throw-in. Beautiful October afternoon here in the Harrogate area. Hopefully we'll have equally as nice conditions this weekend for homecoming festivities. LMU and Queens squaring off Saturday here on the field at the LMU Soccer Complex. Queens, at least for the time, undefeated in league play. Johnson got a piece of it, cleared out of there by Solomons. Pinto comes up on it. And taken away by Carson-Newman's Jake Fielder. Inadvertent handball in the box, not called by the official. I think that was on Lincoln Memorial, but no call. Toward the post, over the crossbar, and that ball will become a goal kick for Lincoln Memorial. Well, Helio Dan is going to get a substitution into the lineup. As it appears, Nick Bogeman's going to check in. I don't know if he'll get in before the goal kick or not, but he is at the midline. Bogeman, 6'2 freshman from Johnson City, Tennessee, product of Science Hill High School. Byrne trying to time that one, didn't get it. Rivera heads it across to Passos, checked back. The Eagles get it back. This is Frame, drops back to midfield. Collins plays it back. Eagles on a run, I believe this is Frame again. Frame penetrates the left corner of the box, shot wide right. The flick by Jake Fielder, just a little bit much for him to handle. It goes wide right, and now we'll have our substitution as LMU will have the goal kick. I don't know. Dana not ready to put Bogeman in yet. And now he's going to put the jersey back on, the penny, as they call it. Marvin Eats, kick across midfield. Nice kick. We'll be trying to pressure the ball a little bit in the Carson-Newman backfield. This is Pereira. Plays it across the midline. Johnson stands him up. Byrne takes it away. Tripped up from behind. No call by the official. Lynn trying to steal it away. Now it's Fielder. Cleared by Lincoln Memorial. And a Carson-Newman player down on the near side. Looked like he took a shot to the right shin. Sanders steals it away. Again, a player still down. No whistle or anything of that nature. Ball played to the keeper. And now the Carson-Newman player up off the ground. Trying to walk it out. I believe that's Jake Fielder. Foster plays it back toward Collins in midfield. Played over to Speak. And taken away by Rivera and Holm on the double team. Up to Villa. And Villa knocked down from behind. No, he was tripped, looked like intentionally, but just the foul called. No yellow card assessed. LMU bench in very big disagreement with the physical contact there, as you can hear them yelling in the background. 8:25 to play in the half, still 1-0 Carson-Newman. Ball toward the corner. Keeper's going to go get it, keep it from going out of play. And now George Burns going to pressure a little bit. Thrown out by the keeper. Played up to Collins. Now drop back far side over to Bakke. This is Laguevel. Near side to Pereira. Collins under pressure. Whiffs it. Pinto up to Byrne. Back over on the chest pass to Yuri Passos. Passos looking for an opening. Over to Pinto. Pinto hits it wide right. Got in a little bit of a hurry. He had such a great look. There was some pressure coming up on him. LMU with an opportunity there and got a little bit ahead of themselves. And with that, a substitution for the Eagles. As the Railsplitters will look back on that one and say, hey, we had the numbers there. That's one that should have gone in frame. Long kick out of the goal, over to the sideline, out of play. That'll be an LMU throw-in. Byrne with the clear foul over there, using the stiff arm to push the defender off. Maybe only a freshman, but he's kind of a man-child out there on the field. I mean, George Byrne, 6'2 freshman from Carlisle, England, went to Queen Elizabeth Grammar School. Big drink of water. Here's Passos on the break for Lincoln Memorial. Collins trying to stand him up, did a nice job. Byrne got it back momentarily, and now a foot race to the ball. Even George Byrne looks small compared to Carson Emmons, Matthias Bocci. He's listed at 6'4". Byrne also listed at 6'2". Another foul across the field. That's going to be a yellow card assessed to Mario Pinto. And a stoppage in play on the hard foul against the Carson-Newman player. You start to see things getting a little bit out of hand here in terms of the physical nature of this contest. And with only 6:01 to play in the first half, we've got a lot of time remaining. Wind blowing nicely, providing a little breeze here at the LMU Soccer Complex. Been extremely hot this afternoon. A lot of sunshine. Folks trying to shade themselves in any way they can. Folks, we'd like to remind you to keep up to date on everything going on with Lincoln Memorial University Athletics. Pull up the LMU Athletics website, www.lmurailsplitters.com. You can find everything you want to know about Lincoln Memorial University Athletics. You may just be an LMU fan. If you are, why, you can check out anything on the 13 NCAA Division II eligible sports. If you have a specific sport that you follow, well, click on that particular part of the website. And again, just enjoy everything that you see there. You can find out all the information that's out there on LMU Athletics. LMU will take possession as a foul was assessed. Possibly, maybe it's a throw-in. In fact, it is a throw-in. They go down line with it, intended for Passos. Carson-Newman gets possession. The Eagles taking it on the attack. Callum Holmes steps up on it, sends it up line. That's off Carson-Newman, and that'll be an LMU throw-in. Rivera on the throw. Ball headed out of play. And again, LMU will throw it in. Bogeman in the lineup now. He missed his entry a minute ago. Via pressuring the keeper a bit. Challenge at midfield. Bogeman trying to play it. Flicks it over to Passos. Passos reversing the field. LMU with some numbers here. Passos running the break. Plays it up to Byrne. Over to Solomon. Solomon's trying to make a cross and an offside call on Lincoln Memorial. Had to be on George Byrne. I really don't know anybody else that it could have been called on. Again, Carson Newman holds LMU off on the attack. Lincoln Memorial with five shots on goal here in the first half. Carson Newman with only three, but they did put one on frame. Stoppage in play. That's going to be a yellow card assessed to Nathaniel Johnson as he knocked the Eagle player to the ground. That was Josh and Nikolai Knoll. You know, that's another thing that coaches have to deal with, and players as well, you know, as you get on throughout the year. Once you get five yellow cards in a on the season, you have to sit out a match, and then you start over. If you get a direct red card, straight red, then you obviously have to sit out. Ball toward the box. Johnson gets ahead on it. That ball knocked out of play. That'll be a throw in for Carson Newman. Thrown in toward the side of the box. LMU got a piece of it. Solomon's being pressured from behind. Plays it over to Lynn. Lynn lost a little something, had to step back on it. Now Johnson will square up LMU's shake. Up to Bogeman. Check pass to Lynn. Through the gap off of one of the Carson Newman players. He'll send it back downfield. Brought down by Holm. Lynn will bring it in. Checks it to Holm. Back to Lynn. Nice ball movement by the Railsplitters. Over to Sanders. Stolen away. I believe that is Speak. And a stoppage in play again on the foul. And another card's coming out. This thing really getting out of hand. Who will it be on? Is that on Lynn? Not sure if there was any intent there. That may be what the official's saying. But a card assessed, I think, to Bryson Lynn, but I can't swear to that. Clock stops at 2:59. This first half taking an eternity to play because of all the stoppages. Kristen Speak. Ready to take the kick for Carson Newman. Official backing the wall off a little bit. Here's Speak. Bends one wide left. So no substitutions. And LMU still down 1-0 as we're under the 3-minute mark. Ball on its way to midfield. Byrne gets ahead on it. Nice header. Bogeman challenging. Can't seem to do anything with it. That ball sent over top of the dugout area, and that'll be a throw in for Lincoln Memorial. Byrne plays it off the feet. Over to Bogeman. Bogeman switches the field to Solomon. Great pass. Solomon left side. Kicked out off the end line. Corner kick, Lincoln Memorial. Railsplitters pushing up. An opportunity to equal this match at 1-1 before the end of the first half. And what momentum that would give Lincoln Memorial going into the break. Solomon will take the corner. Crossing the box, back post, headed toward the goal by Passos, but deflected as well. Sanders trying to bring it down after it was sent toward midfield. Over to Passos, pushed off the ball. And they're going to say that was out off of Lincoln Memorial. Eagles making the run. Tackle from behind on Sanders. And I'm surprised there's no call there with a card because he came in almost. I mean, it was directly behind him. I'm not sure it's the hard foul, but you had to stop that run somehow. I mean, they were looked like they might have even had numbers.
1 minute remaining in the half. 1 minute.
There you have it. Less than 60 seconds remaining in the first half of play. Kick toward the box. Keeper coming up on it. Barbanese hit by his own player. Johnson had backed into him. Roll outlet to Johnson. Sends one up line. Bogeman brings it down. Challenge from behind. Ball knocked out by Carson-Newman. Throw in Lincoln Memorial. 27 seconds remaining in the half. Solomon's looking for options. Try to get it to Byrne. Kicked away from behind. Headed by Solomon's to Byrne. Thrown to the ground. No call by the official. Johnson tied up with one of the Carson-Newman players. Things really getting physical, folks.
10.
And
nine,
a foul
eight,
called on LMU
seven,
with less than 10
six,
seconds left.
5. Four,
and that should do it
three,
for the first half. Carson
two,
Newman takes a 1-0 lead into the break in this South Atlantic Conference regular season matchup. We'll take a timeout when we come back. We'll run down your halftime statistics through Sigmund Communications. This is the LMU Sports Network.
Looking for efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family? Visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite, because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
No matter whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interests at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwich or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner time, choose from our wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches, all made to your order. If you're serving a crowd, Subway has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Whether it's dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. Subway, 362 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Nestled at the foot of the Cumberland Gap, Lincoln Memorial University honors the vision and spirit of Abraham Lincoln. Lincoln's values are perfectly in sync with the modern educational experience at LMU. Our students find personal attention is a way of life and a way to success. If Lincoln Memorial University fits your vision of college, visit our website at lmunet.edu for more information.
The J. Frank White Academy is more than a high school. Your child will have room to grow in mind, body, and spirit. Small, safe learning environments, individualized learning plans, and cutting-edge technology. Every child deserves a quality education in a safe, nurturing environment.
Our college prep program teaches a love of learning, self-discipline, and service to others. The Academy is fully accredited by Advanced Ed. You have a choice at the J. Frank White Academy.
Juggling my family's schedule is a full-time job. Between school, dance practice, work, there's little time left to worry about much else. That's why I use real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. With real-time banking, I know that when I make a deposit, the money goes straight to my account. No delays, no waiting, no wondering. And I get to focus on what's important.
Real-time deposits, real-time access, real-time banking. From Home Federal Bank, always within reach.
At the half here in Harrogate, Tennessee, the Railsplitters trail the Eagles of Carson-Newman 1-0 after the first 45 minutes of play. Let's break down your official halftime statistics. First of all, for the Eagles, it went down like this. Christian Speak with three shots. Jake Fielder had two. He had one assist. In fact, fact, he assisted the goal by Nikolai Knoll. Two shots by Ross Frame. One shot by Duncan Foster. Nicholas Knoll had one as well as one goal. For Lincoln Memorial, Yuri Passos with three shots. Harry Solomon's two. Mario Pinto with two. Pedro Villa with one. Leonardo De Silva one. And Callum Holm one. And that's the extent of it. At the half, LMU with five shots on goal. Carson Newman with three. And as far as the keepers are concerned, Leguevo with five saves, no goals against, 45 minutes on frame. Marcel Barvanich, two saves, one goal against, 45 minutes in the net. At the break, the Railsplitters again trail Carson Newman 1-0. Let's break away once more. We'll be back with your second half shortly right after this on the LMU Sports Network.
Looking for efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family? Visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available, including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine, with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic.
Whether traveling for business or pleasure, Sleep Inn & Suites of Middlesbrough, Kentucky invites you to dream better here. Located at the foothills of the Cumberland Gap, Sleep Inn & Suites offers luxurious rooms equipped with microwave fridge combo, desk, ergonomic chair, wireless internet, and 32-inch flat-screen TV. While staying with us, visit our fitness center, wake up to our complimentary hot breakfast bar, or have a bedtime snack with our fresh-baked cookies. Sleep Inn & Suites, located off Highway 25E, Middlesbrough.
Since 1973, DeRoyal has been a leader and an innovator in manufacturing products for the healthcare industry. DeRoyal supplies more than 20,000 products and product lines such as acute care, orthopedics, wound care, and trauma. DeRoyal is proud to be the largest supplier of orthopedic soft goods to clinics and hospitals in the nation. Since its start in Tazewell, Tennessee, DeRoyal has grown to open factories in over 29 locations worldwide and employs over 2,000 people. DeRoyal, a name you can trust and an employer you can count on.
For great food, fun, and entertainment, visit the Oasis on Highway 25E in Harrogate, Tennessee, with a new drive-thru to better serve you. At the Oasis, you can enjoy a great lunch buffet or order from the great menu that the tri-state area has grown to love. Pizza, salad bar, and a tasty sandwich from the deli. And don't forget your favorite beverages. Check out the live music each week at the Oasis, where regional and local bands strut their stuff to a packed house. Or stop by and catch the big race on the big screen. All roads lead to the Oasis. 6341 Cumberland Gap Parkway in Harrogate, Tennessee. Phone in your order, 423-869-8000.
Make K&K Metal Sales your only stop for all your residential and commercial metal building needs. For the past 23 years, K&K Metal Sales has covered the tri-state area with quality custom roofing and siding with many grades, gauges, and colors in stock. If you're looking for complete steel or wood building packages or steel or wood trusses, K&K Metal Sales can help with that, as well as heavy-duty custom carports. Great folks and great prices. Stop by K&K Metal Sales located at 6986 Cumberland Gap Parkway or call 423-869-4261.
At Farm Bureau Insurance, you can manage your auto, home, and life policies any way you want. If you like the internet, get a quote and file claims online at FBITN.com. If you like to take care of your business over the phone, give us a call. If you like to email, send us a message and we'll take care of you that way. But if you like an old-fashioned smile and handshake at the door, come down to the local office.
Today's broadcast of Lincoln Memorial University Soccer is brought to you by University Medical Clinic, with two locations to serve you in Harrogate and New Tazewell, Tennessee. University Medical Clinic. By Farm Bureau Insurance. By Old Town Grill. By Home Federal Bank of Harrogate. Always within reach, Home Federal Bank. By Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough. Eat fresh at Subway. By Holiday Inn Express of Middlesbrough. Sleep smart at Holiday Inn Express. By Oasis Pizza and Substation. By DeRoyal, a name you can trust, a product you can count on. DeRoyal. By K&K Metal Sales. By Sleep Inn of Middlesbrough. Dream better here at Sleep Inn. By the J. Frank White Academy. And by Lincoln Memorial University. Your career path is here.
Welcome back to the LMU Soccer Complex as the Railsplitters trail the Eagles of Carson-Newman University 1-0 after the first 45 minutes of play. Lincoln Memorial and Carson-Newman now ready to square off. And it appears as though Carson-Newman may have made a keeper change. Let me get a clarification, guys. Looks like Carson-Newman might have made a keeper change. We'll have to wait and see. The two keepers wearing the same uniforms practically, so hard to really tell. It might be the same keeper. McGuevel was the keeper in the net first 45 minutes, and he may still be. We'll have a clarification on that, but we are underway here in Harrogate, and it will be LMU that gets possession as we go into the final 45 minutes of regulation. Lincoln Memorial has had their opportunities, but unable to put one on frame in the first half. Carson-Newman possession. Well, apparently that is the same keeper. He's wearing the same jersey. He looked a little bit smaller out there than I remember him in the first half. He switched ends of the field, so. Eagles at the box, and another goal. Less than 45 seconds into the second half, Ross Frame scores his second goal of the match. 5'11 junior from the United Kingdom puts the Eagles on top 2-0.
Carson-Newman goal for number 21.
And for the Railsplitters, that is a huge hole to dig their way out of with, for essential purposes, 45 minutes to play. The entire team standing out there with hands on hip, staring back toward the Carson-Newman goal. Not exactly sure what happened there, but some kind of breakdown, and a great shot by Frame. Lynn starting the second half for Lincoln Memorial. This is home out of the defensive backfield. Plays it over to Johnson. Johnson going long ball, far sideline, intended for Solomons. Solomons keeps it in play. Da Silva will gain possession. Plays it back to Johnson. Johnson trying to get it back to Solomons, but Carson-Newman comes down with it. Cross and switch of the field. Some speed in the lineup for the Eagles now, as blowing around Mario Pinto are the fresh legs of Jalen Goddard. The Eagles threatening again, and Passos taking it away. Passos on the break up the field, throws Goddard off, sends a ball toward the middle, keeper comes up on it, checks it up the field. Headed back towards Barvanites, and he'll grab it up. This is Johnson. Boy, lightning struck quick here in the second half. 2-0 Carson-Newman. Sanders on the run for Lincoln Memorial. Stays on his feet. Gives off to Villa near sideline. Villa looking over his options. Forced to play it back to Rivera. Back to Villa near the corner. Scrambling to get there. Keeps it in play. Cross to the far post. Wheeling on it is Solomons off the head of one of the Carson-Newman defenders, and it'll be taken on the end line by the Eagles' Trejo. Trejo sending it deep up the field across the midline. Brought down nicely by Frame again. And now Lincoln Memorial trying to deny the Eagles a shot on goal. Throw in far side for Carson-Newman. Looked like quite possibly the Eagle defender pulled up a little lame on that exchange. Rowan goes to speak. LMU dugout silent over there after that goal. 2-0 Carson-Newman. He
Eagles trying to work something around over there. Speak trying to get loose. Ball played back far sideline. Comes out to Collins. Goddard outside the top of the box. Trying to fire one away. Rivera steals it from him. Gives up to Solomons. Solomons under pressure. Ball knocked out far sideline by Carson Newman. And LMU will have the throw in. That'll be Lynn to step out to do it. Lays it back to Johnson. Over to Holm, deep ball up the field. Headed toward the box area. Villa brings it down, but that's the big man, Bakke, that comes up with it for Carson Newman, and Villa knocks it out of play. Carson Newman throw in. Long throw down line. Brought in by Goddard. Stolen away again by Passos. Pinto plays it back to Johnson. Now Rivera showing up line. Keeps it in play. Pushed out at the end line, and that'll be touched last by Lincoln Memorial. Let's see if they give. Yep, that's going to be goal kick. They're going to say it was out of play before Rivera touched it. Exactly 5 minutes in as we have a huge deficit to make up here, down 2-0. Lincoln Memorial trying to keep from falling below the 500 mark again. They're 4-4-1 overall, 2-2-1 in sack play. And a loss here this afternoon will drop them down below 500 in both those categories. Passos getting to it at midfield. Plays it over the defender. Touch pass to Pinto. Pinto. Actually, that's not Pinto. That's De Silva. Beg your pardon. De Silva being stood up. Crosses one. Headed out of play off the end line. And that'll be an LMU corner kick. De Silva had Bakke in his face there. And really neither wanted to give much. And chose to go around him with the right leg. Cross. Pinto hits it back toward the top of the box. De Silva trying to get there, but now Lynn comes up on it. Hit into the box. Johnson going up in the air. Had some hands up there, and I think the keeper didn't like that a whole lot. Punted out, deep downfield, brought down by Carson Newman's fielder. Over to Speak. Now kicked out by Yuri Passos. Eagles deep in LMU territory now as they have the throw-in. Check back to Fielder. Cross in the box. Lynn trying to get there, and Barbadietz will grab it up. Eight minutes to play. Johnson. Upfield to De Silva. Played back now to Holm. Over to Rivera. Up line to Villa. Passos. To Villa. He tried to push the defender off. Rivera trying to take it away. Ball out of play, and that'll be a throw-in for Lincoln Memorial at midfield. Holm switching the field opposite side. It's Johnson. And it'll go back to Carson Newman as that ball was way offline. So hard to play from behind when you're down 2-0 and you got that much time ahead. But then you'd also know that there's plenty of time you can get back into this match if you just execute. Here's Speak carrying some space. And an offside call against the Eagles. Carson Newman scoring less than 45 seconds into the second half. And that alone has put the Eagles way out in front 2-0. Header by Trejo across midfield. Still fighting for the ball. Comes up with it. Rips one across the crossbar. Had a shot from about 40 yards out, maybe even more than that. 45 maybe. Got to try that every now and then. Saw it happen twice in the women's match, one for each team. Sanders trying to challenge. Home getting to it. Shields the defender, and LMU will have the throw-in. Down line to Villa. Brings it down. Villa plays it up to Passos. Passos knocked to the ground from behind by Collins, and the foul on Carson-Newman. Long ball up the line. That's to Villa out of play. LMU getting in a little bit of a hurry. Substitution ready to check in for the Railsplitters. Looks like that's George Byrne ready to check in. And he will not be allowed to come in until LMU has the throw-in. Passos heads it back toward the Carson-Newman area of the field. Here's Rivera. Nice pass off to Da Silva, around the defender. Da Silva hopping the goalkeeper. And tell you what, Carson Newman's goalkeepers have been impressive today, both of them, men and women. Long ball upfield. Johnson trying to get there for Lincoln Memorial. Sends it up line, and a foul on Carson Newman. That'll be LMU possession. Under the 35-minute mark, actually approaching the 34-minute mark. Rivera near side of the field. Across the midline. They're not showing him a lot of respect, letting him carry some space. Here's Passos. Touch pass up to Da Silva. Da Silva rips one. Deflection off of the Carson-Newman defender, I thought. Apparently not. So Byrne returns, Land goes out, and the goal kick will come from Carson Newman. Byrne will move up top. That'll push Solomons back on the defensive mid. Rivera undercut a bit, no call by the official. Villa comes down with it. Over to Da Silva. Back to Passos. Drop pass to Rivera. And back to home. Switch of field over to Byrne. I beg your pardon. Johnson. Passos. Tried to get it to Rivera. That ball out of play. .38 remaining. Challenge for the ball. Brought down by the Eagles, but possession taken by Lincoln Memorial. Solomon got it. Solomon's heads one out of play, and that'll be a Carson-Newman throw-in. Railsplitters will have their hands full this Saturday when they play host to the Queens Royals. Here's Passos on the break. Railsplitters trying to make something happen. Over to Da Silva. Now to Byrne. Big guy rambling down through there. Crosses one in the box. Pinto hits it. And it goes wide right. Wheeled on that one. Not a bicycle, but he wheeled on it. Sent it to the far post. Couldn't get it there. The opportunities that LMU has had today, they've had enough
5-4, your shots on goal. Lincoln Memorial leads the category, but for Carson-Newman, they put two of them on frame. So 50% of their shots on frame have gone in. Rivera heads it back toward Passos. Up to Villa. Villa being held up a little bit, no call. Cuts it back toward the center, rips a shot, past the keeper in the right side. And LMU has cut the deficit 2-1. Just a great effort by the Railsplitters. That started off the header by Gus Rivera. And Lincoln Memorial is back in this one with 31-13 to play. Still some ground to make
LMU
up.
Go by number 18, Pedro Villa.
But now you know that all you have to have is one shot, and that ties the match. So 2-1, Carson-Newman, but LMU striking back, fighting back. And the match is underway again. Rivera, flick kick to Villa, goes out of play, throw in for the Eagles. Nice goal by Villa. They were looking for Pinto to maybe take hold of it. Collins, long ball to the far side of the field, pulling it in his fielder, if he can get there. He does not. Well, Solomons will have the throw in for Lincoln Memorial. Johnson drops back and takes it. Long ball up the far sideline. Headed back across the midline by Carson-Newman. And now Holm will reel it in. Long pass over here to Passos. Nice flick up to Villa. Villa trying to get there. Foot race. Kicked out by Carson-Newman. Contact made by Bakke. And LMU with a throw-in. Passos stood up defensively. Kicked out by the Eagles. Here's Sanders with the ball toward the top of the box. Checked out. Sanders will head it back. And now on the run, it's Frame. Foul called on Lincoln Memorial at midfield. That'll be Carson-Newman possession. Some pushing going on out there between Christian Speak and Keegan Sanders. Ball toward the LMU keeper's area, and Barvanich goes up and gets it. Long kick by Barvanich, header by Byrne. Third ball brought down by Da Silva, and played back to Solomons. Up to Byrne, the big guy being pressured heavily on the defensive end. And that ball knocked out, last touch by Lincoln Memorial. Throw in for the Eagles, but a substitution as well. With 28:44 to play, going out of the match will be, I don't know if that was Goddard or not, but looked like Cendre Wheelo checked back in there. Chip pass, Solomons clears it. Might have actually been, can't tell if that's Solomons or Sanders. Header by Johnson. Byrne. I don't know why I've confused those two today. They look nothing alike. Here's Bakke near sideline. Looking upfield for the Eagles. Over to Trejo. Wheelo getting pressure from LMU's Gus Rivera. Switch of the field, far side now for Carson-Newman. Ball deflected. Johnson heads it out. Here's Wheelo. LMU knocks it away. Pinto, they got a piece of it. Now Sanders over to Solomons and back to the defensive backfield of Lincoln Memorial. Yeah.
Marvin Eats. Here's Villa. Chip shot up to Pinto. Brings it in. Pinto lost it for a moment. Thrown to the ground. Foul on Carson Newman. Pinto still down, and he got the foul. We'll see what LMU can do with it. Clock running in Carson Newman's favor. So, Eagles really content with LMU taking as much time as they want, but the Railsplitters really kind of hurting themselves using as much clock as they are. Two-one Eagles lead it, 26-10 to play in the regulation here. And Pinto will fire a shot, deflected, gets it back, battling for the loose ball. Here's Sanders. Sanders rips one, again deflected. Carson Newman clears the ball. And that ball heading toward midfield. Johnson pushed off the ball at midfield. And that's inadvertent. That will be a foul nonetheless on Carson Newman. Deep ball to the far sideline. Kicked out of play. That'll be a throw in now for the Eagles. Johnson playing it back to Barvanites. High ball toward midfield by Barvanites. Second ball. That's Philip Roulet, 6'1 junior out of Knoxville, Tennessee, in the lineup for Lincoln Memorial now. I didn't catch him in a minute ago. Coach Dana possibly looking for some size in the lineup that can get up there and win some headers. Here's Sanders, back to Roulet. Home pushing up on it across midfield. Ball cleared by the Eagles. And knocked out of play. That'll be a throw in for Lincoln Memorial. Here's Holmes sending a deep ball downfield. Villa pressuring a bit, but that one way out in front of him, and Carson Newman keeper with no problem to go over there and just milk some clock. That's got to be aggravating when you see him just standing there. They're not going to pick it up until they have to. Wheelhouse kick by Carson Newman's keeper. Home header to the near sideline and out of play. Throw in for Lincoln Memorial far side. And a substitution also for the Railsplitters. As Roulet will go out, and I believe that's Yuri Passos that had been out of the lineup. He checks back in. Eagles trying to send it downfield. Challenge at midfield. Sanders brings it down. Plays it over to Lincoln Memorial. That's Rivera. Passos off the Carson Newman defender and out of play. Rivera with the throw in. LMU crowd really not into this one a whole lot right now because Railsplitter opportunities are few and far between at this point in the match. But they have cut to within one, and so you know that all it takes is just one hit. Rivera crosses one top of the box, thinks somebody got a piece of it. Nothing but blue jerseys there on that flick out of there. Eagles with the run. Solomon's trying to stand up the Carson Newman player. And there's the all-conference defender, Callum Holm, that steps up and cuts off the run. Here's Villa up the far sideline, carrying a lot of space. Villa still running it, gives it up to Da Silva. Now up to Pinto.
Pinto back over to Da Silva. Da Silva shot wide right. And a goal kick for Carson Newman. 21:55 to play here in Harrogate. Only regular season meeting between these two programs. Nice kick again by the Carson Newman keeper. Header back across by Byrne. He challenges everything. You got to love that.
Such a physical match today. Throw in for the Eagles. I'm not sure the Railsplitters like the call. Now Carson Newman's going to leave it. Again, trying to use some of that clock. It's clock management here. They know they have the lead. They can do that legally. Cross heading to the near side. Rivera stepping up on it out of the box. He'll take the run on his own, plays it toward midfield, and it'll be taken back by Trejo of Carson Newman. Collins playing it back to his teammates in the defensive backfield. Near side pass to Fielder. Rivera steals it away. And somehow Carson Newman kept possession. Dangerous ball in the box. And a foul on the Eagles. As there's some pushing going on again between Keegan Sanders and looks like Trejo. Long ball up the middle. Nice header by Carson Newman to get it back toward midfield. Frame plays it far side. Sanders. Across the midline, Passos got a bump from behind. Byrne looking to get rid of it. Turns and hits it right to the Carson Newman player. That's Sakota. Can't tell, looked like nine, but it may not have been. Sanders playing it back to home again. Callum Holm is swung on some balls today, and I mean absolutely knocked him all the way up the field. His legs got to be killing him. Get it! Da Silva stood up, foul on the Railsplitters, and again Carson Newman takes over possession. Now to the 20-minute mark. Lincoln Memorial hoping to get back in this one, but since the goal, they have had very few opportunities to take shots. Carson Newman defense has tightened up a bit. No longer have that cushion. Da Silva thrown down at midfield, foul on the Eagles. Memorial still trying to get back into this one. Johnson plays it far side over to Solomons. Solomons keeps possession, although really being harassed over there. Stolen back by Carson Newman. Pass to the far sideline. Railsplitters trying to maintain their energy level here. Sanders again has it taken away. Carson Newman with the advantage here. Nice job by Johnson, and wisely he clears it out. The sophomore opting to send it out off the sideline rather than give up the goal, and that's the good decision. Now that'll allow some of his teammates to get back defensively, and we got a player down, so a stoppage in play with 17:47 to go. Some players starting to cramp up now due to the heat and the extreme play of this game, and 2-1 Lincoln Memorial. It looks like that's Solomon's down over there, at least for the time, and somebody else stretching out a couple of hamstrings and calves, as that looks to be Nathaniel Johnson. So the throw-in will come to the Eagles. Ball off off the end line, and a goal kick for Lincoln Memorial. Substitution for the Railsplitters as Bryson Lynn returns, and that'll send Da Silva out of the game. .17:20 to play. Home will try to move it upfield for Lincoln Memorial. Sends it up to Passos. Chip shot pass up and across the midline intended for Villa. Headed back by Carson Newman. This is Frame who sends it down toward the end line, and Barvanich comes out and gets it. Outlet throw to Johnson. Most of the last few minutes have been played on the LMU end of the field. That's what's concerning. Long ball up to Solomon, sent back by Carson Newman. Rivera trying to bring it down at midfield, does that, using the footwork. Ball kept in play, now out, and it'll be a Carson Newman throw-in. The Eagles really haven't used a great deal of substitutions today. Crossover into the box, and again, Barvanich comes out on it. Grabs it up, no threat down there, and he's going to send it upfield. Byrne trying to get there, goes out of bounds on the far side of the field, and that'll go back to Carson Newman. Four matches this year that the Railsplitters have gone to overtime. They've played nine. And the last thing you'd really want to see is to go to overtime, but if that's what you got to do to win, so be it. LMU's not won an overtime match this year. Villa losing the handle on it. They've lost three and tied one. Some unlucky bounces, unlucky breaks. That's soccer, according to Coach Dana. Throwing across midfield, headed back by Holm towards center field. Penso trying to bring it down. Rips one wide left of the post. LMU getting in a hurry there. And I think they're going to call a foul on Carson Newman before the actual shot. And again, Richard Moody, head coach of the Eagles, pacing the sidelines over there like a expectant father. Corner kick, cross to the right bar. Byrne trying to get there, kicks it back toward midfield. Carson Newman, player there. Frame battling with Rivera. And it'll be taken by the Eagles' Bakke. Sanders knocks it out at midfield. .14 minutes to play. Railsplitters looking for the equalizer, but they've got to get it back first. Here's Holm. Sends it up line. Byrne ready for it. Tries to bring it down. Collins will run in front of it, but taken by Pinto. Pass far side to Lynn. And pushed off the ball a bit, got it back, kicked it off the defender. Throws it into Solomons. Played back to Sanders. Over to Passos. Up to Villa. Stolen away by Trejo. Kicked back toward midfield. Challenged by Sanders off the head. Lynn trying to bring it down. He's pressured from behind. Gets the push. No call by the official. Plays it back to Johnson. Now over to Holm. Railsplitters are possessing better, but they're not getting shot opportunities. Header back to the Carson Newman keeper. And again, just playing keep away from the Railsplitters as Pinto steps up and pressures. Rivera takes it away. Pressured from behind. Pushed off the ball. The takeaway by Speak. And he'll still run the break for Carson Newman. Nice tackle by Lincoln Memorial University's Harry Solomons. And taken right back by the Eagles. Rivera again steals it back. LMU crowd trying to get behind the Railsplitters now. Passos on the break. Looking for help. Dumps it off. Here's Rivera from the outside. Rivera trying to shake the defender enough to get across. Drops back to Passos to the top of the box. Nothing but blue jerseys there. Stepping up on it now is Sanders. Sanders making a run, covering some space. Comes to the right side of the box. Chip shot in the frame. Headed out. Villa knocks it over to Passos. LMU trying to restructure here. Chip shot up to Solomons, kicked away by Bakke. And that'll be a throw-in for Lincoln Memorial. Let's see if LMU can lock this one in. Closest they've been in a while. Substitution for the Railsplitters. And most likely that's going to be Da Silva that comes back in as Solomons will go out and get a break. 11:15 to go. Here's the throw-in from Rivera. Burn in the box, header toward the keeper. Chipped by Pinto, and we're tied at two. Rivera to Burn to Pinto. We are tied at two. Lincoln Memorial finding the equalizer, and Burn down on the field. I don't know if he's just exhausted, but he's being picked up by his teammates, and suddenly the Railsplitters are back in this match. Gus Rivera, a great throw. And George Byrne, the freshman, getting ahead on it. Pinto, last year's league-leading scorer, knew exactly what to do with it. Blew it by the keeper. Tied at two, Lincoln Memorial. And Carson Newman with 11 minutes remaining in regulation. That's what I said. It just takes one. Long ball up the near sideline. Pinto trying to get there. Bakke looking to head it back to the keeper. Pinto pressuring. Long kick across midfield. Lynn going up and challenging that ball, and he'll be called for the foul. Now Bryson Lynn is only 5'8", a freshman out of Hendersonville, Tennessee, and going up against the much larger Carson Newman defender. Ball played over to Fielder. Chip to the far side. Lynn heads it back. Byrne trying to wheel on it and kick it back towards center field. That'll go out of play. Throw in for the Eagles in front of their own dugout. Header by Sanders. Again going back to Carson Newman. Ten minutes to go. Ball in the box, gets loose. Carson Newman player still down. He got tied up with Gus Rivera. And I'll tell you what, Richard Moody is over there giving the officials what for. Long ball up to Pinto. Pinto wheels on it. Keeper makes a great save. Pinto pushed off the ball, blows it again. And I'm telling you, the keeper laying out to make that grab. And LMU all over Carson Newman in this last couple of exchanges. Challenge for the ball at two-thirds field. Last touch by Lincoln Memorial. Pinto back-to-back shots on goal. Keeper's holding his ground nicely. Here's home. Sends it up toward midfield. Da Silva trying to bring it down. Does a nice shot. Actually, that's Pinto. Taken away by Carson Newman. Rivera pressing. Ball up line. Uh-oh, trouble here. Fielder crosses top of the box. Johnson will come out of there with it. That was a great play by Lynn to keep the defender from having a shot, rather. And now it's Da Silva that runs the break. LMU with some numbers here. Plays the ball up to Burns. Burns from the deep corner. Back to Da Silva. Da Silva looking to rip one. And the keeper, a great save. Here's Pinto. Pinto to the right side.
LMU on top, 3-2, by virtue of nothing more than a barrage of shots. Holy cow, just like that, LMU takes a 3-2 advantage with 8:26 to play.
LMU goal by number 10, Mario Pinto.
Just an unbelievable save by Romuald Leguevel. And off the rebound, Mario Pinto punches it in the right side. And just like that, after going down 2-0, Lincoln Memorial comes back to score three unanswered goals. Couple of substitutions in there for Lincoln Memorial. Philip Roulier in there to give some of his teammates a break. Just a couple of minutes. Eagles now trying to press. Here's Speak. Gives it off near side over to Fielder. Back to Speak. Flick knocked away by Villa. Speak running the sideline. Stood up by Rivera. Crosses it. Rivera kicks it away. Here's Collins. Rips one toward the right side. Goes out off the end line. And right here is where you're in no hurry. The clock's working in your favor now. You pull the Carson-Newman trick here and try to, try to use some clock. 7:40 to go. Railsplitter's on top by a goal, 3-2. Just a gutsy performance. I mean, it was not looking good, folks. LMU came out of nowhere. I heard somebody in the crowd just now say they are not done, and that is an absolute understatement. Carson-Newman will do everything they can to get back into this match. Header across midfield. Rivera racing to get there. Clears it up and across the midline. Villa takes it around the defender. Great effort. Chip shot up to Da Silva, who was way offside. And he knew it immediately as he was looking back at the official. He was only about 8 yards from the official, the line judge, if you will. And so with that, Carson-Newman, the keeper, will come out and get things going again. We're under the 7-minute mark. Ball up the field. This is intended for Noel. Chip shot into the box. Headed out by Rivera. Nothing but Sanders there, and he'll send it up the field. This is intended for Da Silva. Right now it was 1v1. Da Silva in a foot race, pushed off the ball a bit, taken away by Pereira. LMU crowd wanting some contact. No call by the official. Lynn steps up far side, kicks it out of play, throw in far side of the field for the Eagles. That'll be right at the dugout, 50 mark of the field. Johnson gets it back to Passos. Passos sending it down line. Challenged by Byrne, but unfortunately headed out up on top of the dugout. Again, throw in by the Eagles. Johnson, second ball, headed away. That'll be Lincoln Memorial possession as it touched Carson-Newman last. Whistle by the official. Long throw in, cross midfield. Da Silva trying to bring it down, does so. Knocked out by Carson-Newman, still LMU possession. So Burns going to step out over there. Again, no hurry to get to it. Now he'll leave it. And a stoppage in play now by the referee with 5:16 to go on the clock. Bryson Lynn will throw it in. Time not running. Boy, Helio Dana hot about something over there. Not sure if he's talking to the referee or to his team. Mario Pinto held by the defender. No call again. Long ball up the field. Passos brings it down. This is Sanders being trailed. Plays it over to Rivera. And Rivera looking for help and options as he squares up. Roulier trying to play it to Villa. Now it's knocked back to home. Home has plenty of time. Sends a deep ball intended for Villa.
brings it in, keeps it in front of him, taken away by Trejo. Now stolen back by Villa. And Villa takes it down line. Tackle from behind, and I don't know, looked like studs up right there to me, but no foul, only the foul called, no card given. 4:34 to go in this match in regulation. LMU on top 3-2. So Yuri Passos will step over to the point of foul. And Lincoln Memorial utilizing as much clock as the officials will let him get away with. Carson-Newman coaching staff up in arms over there. And an offside call on Lincoln Memorial as apparently that was De Silva that was offside. Played back to the keeper for Carson-Newman, Laguevel. Clock under 4 minutes. Eagles on the attack now as they'll try to push it across midfield. You don't want to let them get too deep. Ball to Johnson, headed back. Passos bicycles it. Brought down by Carson Newman's fielder. Now Trejo back to fielder. Switches the field, far side. Ball into the box, tight to the goal. And whiffed. I don't think anybody touched it. They're going to say it was a corner. Didn't look like LMU made contact. Linesman far side said corner. The referee said corner. Dangerous for Lincoln Memorial because you got so many long bodies out there for Carson Newman. Guys that can get up in the air and get ahead on it. And now LMU's going to really have to play some tight defense. Down to the three-minute mark. Here's the corner kick across the box. Kicked around. That ball will go out off of Carson Newman and a goal kick for the Railsplitters. Stoppage in play with 2:53 on the clock. LMU with a substitution. Mario Pinto is going to return to the lineup, and that'll be Leonardo De Silva that comes out. Just an eternity remaining in this match if you're out there on that field and sometimes here in the stands as well. 2:53 to play. Here's Barvanitz on the goal kick. Long ball up and across midfield. And the Eagles headed out of play, so LMU will have the throw-in from that area. Gus Rivera ready to do it. Throw in to Passos. He'll go upfield with it. Pinto trying to bring it down. Flicks it over to Villa. Villa through the legs of the defender. Pinto tripped up, and a card will be assessed to Carson Newman as there was no intent. Trejo will get the yellow card. And Pinto... The foul to Pinto, rather, stops the clock with 2:31 to play. Clock not running, so really it makes no difference how much time. The clock now starts. Passo stood up by the defender, plays it to Byrne on the sideline. Byrne holding the much smaller defender off easily. Takes it into the corner. That ball rolls out of play, and that will be a Carson Newman possession. And Byrne was shielding the defender. I don't know. I think he disagreed with it, but hard to really tell who touched it last. Eagles trying to cover some space here. Flick to the far sideline. 2 minutes to go. Carson Newman trying to find the equalizer. Cleared by Sanders into the Eagle dugout. Throw in by Carson Newman, far side of the field. 1:45 to go. Chip toward the box, headed out by Johnson. Roulet sends it back toward midfield. Here's Trejo. Sanders trying to stay with him defensively. Trejo off the left side of the box, stood up by LMU. 1:20 on the clock. Bakke heads it out straight away. Here's Collins, rips one toward the top of the box. Pereira looking for a shot, cleared by Holm, a high ball that still hadn't come down yet. Brought down by Villa, and it'll go out off of Lincoln Memorial with 1 minute remaining in the match. Right here is where it goes, just absolutely as hard as you can for the next 60 seconds. Foul on Lincoln Memorial. The Eagles will get possession. 49 seconds to go. Clock still running, 43 seconds. Carson Newman, coaching staff over there screaming at the officials. Across the top of the box, comes to the near corner. Eagles trying to hang on to it, sends down to the box, and falling on it is Barbanides with 23 seconds to play. And Barbanides ready for the punt. High arcing ball that's going to come right down at about midfield. Off Carson Newman, and that's going to do it right there, folks. The Eagles fall here today as LMU comes from two goals down, 3-2, and defeat the Carson-Newman Eagles to move to 5-4-1 on the year. More importantly, 3-2-1 in South Atlantic Conference play. LMU wins it. We'll take this break. Be back with your final wrap-up. This is the Lincoln Memorial University Sports Network.
Looking for efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family? Visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite. Because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
No matter whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interests at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwich or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner time, choose from our wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches, all made to your order. If you're serving a crowd, Subway has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Whether it's dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. Subway, 362 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
I've been a hard worker all my life. It's just the way I was raised. I work the third shift. While most people are wrapping up their day, I'm just getting started. If I make a deposit on Friday night, I can't wait for it to go through the next week. Home Federal Bank's real-time banking is different. Real-time banking takes the worry out of banking. Lets me think about what's important.
Real-time deposits, real-time access. Real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. Always within reach.
The J. Frank White Academy is more than a high school. Your child will have room to grow in mind, body, and spirit. Small, safe learning environments, individualized learning plans, and cutting-edge technology. Every child deserves a quality education in a safe, nurturing environment.
Our college prep program teaches a love of learning, self-discipline, and service to others. The Academy is fully accredited by Advanced Ed. You have a choice at the J. Frank White Academy.
When you're traveling throughout the tri-states, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express of Middlesbrough. With nearly 60 rooms to choose from, fitness center, full complimentary hot breakfast bar, and seasonal pool, Holiday Inn Express of Middlesbrough is all about catering to your travel needs. Our rooms are all equipped with flat-screen TV, refrigerator, microwave, and we're conveniently located just seconds from the area's attractions. When you're on the road, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express, located on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesbrough. Make reservations today by calling 606-248-6860.
Back once again, the LMU Soccer Complex here on the Lincoln Memorial University campus. The Railsplitters come from two goals down to take a 3-2 win over Carson Newman in regulation. Just an unbelievable second half by Lincoln Memorial. And it came at a point, really, the things got turned around for LMU at a point where all of a sudden the game had just kind of gone into a lull. It had gone very flat. LMU got one breakaway. They made it. They capitalized on it. They got that goal by Pedro Villa. It was unassisted, dribbled from the right side to the top of the box and put it in the lower corner. After that, that was in the 59th minute, by the way. After that, it was 20 minutes later, the Railsplitters' Mario Pinto scored his seventh goal of the season with an assist from George Byrne
off of a throw-in by Gus Rivera. It chipped in following a quick pass off the throw-in. LMU ties the match at 2-2. The game winner comes in the 82nd minute when Mario Pinto scores unassisted, put in from the right side off of the deflection from the save by Carson-Newman keeper Rumweld Laguevel. LMU on the afternoon, well, they improved to 5-4-1 with the win, 3-2-1 in South Atlantic Conference play. Carson-Newman falls to 5-4-0, 2-3 in league action. The statistics went down as follows for Carson-Newman: Christopher Trejo with one shot, Duncan Foster had one, Christian Speak with three shots, one shot on goal, Matthias Bakke with one shot, two by Jake Fielder. He also had one of the assists on the goal. Nico Knoll with a shot, one shot on goal, one goal. Ross Frame, three shots, two on goal, one goal. And Rurik Pereira with one shot, as well as Jalen Gollard. For Lincoln Memorial, it went down in the book like this. And by the way, LMU outshot Carson-Newman 22-14, 11 shots to 4, which were on Frame. Callum Holm, one shot on goal. Yuri Passos, three shots, two on goal. Leonardo Da Silva, four shots, one on goal. George Byrne had an assist. Mario Pinto, nine shots, four on goal, two goals. Harry Solomons, two shots, one on goal. Pedro Villa, two shots, two on goal, one goal. Gus Rivera had an assist in that throw-in. Keegan Sanders with one shot. And LMU wins it here today, 3-2 over the Carson-Newman Eagles. Tough match for the Railsplitters, but when we talked with Kelly O'Dana earlier in the week, we knew it would be. These two teams play so hard due to the rivalry, due to the South Atlantic Conference standings, due to the closeness and proximity. And today it was just the Railsplitters' day. It didn't look like it was going to be, but you got to take your hats off to LMU to battle from two goals down and not pick up their first goal until the 59th minute. Doesn't happen like that very often. You don't want it to happen like that very often. You don't want to be in that situation. Nonetheless, LMU captures the 3-2 win over Carson-Newman, and they now look into Saturday to do what no other team in the league has been able to do when the Queens Royals come to town. They'll take on an undefeated South Atlantic Conference team. By the way, the only undefeated team in the league, and that is in league play. They've been beaten once overall, but it'll be an interesting matchup this coming week. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we'll talk with your University Medical Clinic offensive and defensive players of the match. We're not going to tell you who those are. You're going to have to stay around to find out. Back after this on the LMU Sports Network.
Looking for efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family? Visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available, including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine, with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite, because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
No matter whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interests at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwich or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner time, choose from our wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches, all made to your order. If you're serving a crowd, Subway has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Whether it's dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. Subway, 362 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Since 1973, DeRoyal has been a leader and an innovator in manufacturing products for the healthcare industry. DeRoyal supplies more than 20,000 products and product lines such as acute care, orthopedics, wound care, and trauma. DeRoyal is proud to be the largest supplier of orthopedic soft goods to clinics and hospitals in the nation. Since its start in Tazewell, Tennessee, DeRoyal has grown to open factories in over 29 locations worldwide and employs over 2,000 people. DeRoyal, a name you can trust and an employer you can count on.
At Farm Bureau Insurance, you can manage your auto, home, and life policies any way you want.
If you like the internet, get a quote and file claims online at FBITN.com. If you like to take care of your business over the phone, give us a call. If you like to email, send us a message and we'll take care of you that way. But if you like an old-fashioned smile and handshake at the door, come down to the local office.
Juggling my family's schedule is a full-time job. Between school, dance practice, work, there's little time left to worry about much else. That's why I use real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. With real-time banking, I know that when I make a deposit, the money goes straight to my account. No delays, no waiting, no wondering. And I get to focus on what's important.
Real-time deposits, real-time access, real-time banking. From Home Federal Bank, always within reach.
Today's broadcast of Lincoln Memorial University Soccer has been brought to you by University Medical Clinic, with two locations to serve you in Harrogate and New Tazewell, Tennessee. University Medical Clinic. By Farm Bureau Insurance. By Old Town Grill. By Home Federal Bank of Harrogate, always within reach. Home Federal Bank. By Subway of Harrogate and Middlesboro. Eat fresh at Subway. By Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro. Sleep smart at Holiday Inn Express. By Oasis Pizza and Substation. By DeRoyal, a name you can trust, a product you can count on. DeRoyal. By K&K Metal Sales. By Sleep Inn of Middlesboro. Dream better here at Sleep Inn. By the J. Frank White Academy. And by Lincoln Memorial University. Your career path is here.
Welcome back to the LMU Soccer Complex. The Railsplitters make a come-from-behind win here today over the Carson-Newman Eagles to win it 3-2. LMU down 2-0. Actually less than 45 seconds into the second half. First goal didn't come for the Railsplitters until the 59th minute. That was scored by Pedro Villa. Mario Pinto scored the final two goals, including the game winner. But your University Medical Clinic player, defensive player of the match, Gus Rivera. First of all, congratulations, Gus.
Thank you.
Let's talk about this match today. We knew this one was going to be a tough one coming in, and I really didn't quite frankly know how big Carson-Newman was out there on the pitch until I saw him out on the field today. But, you know, they've got so many guys out there that are so tall, long, and lean, and they get up in the box very well. They get up and down the field well. For you as a defender who's a guy of smaller stature, is that a tough thing to overcome?
Yeah, of course. Carson-Newman, they're always a physical team. They like to bang the ball around and bang the players around, and it's just something you have to deal with.
Among the matches we've played this year, and I think this is number 10, somewhere in that area, how does this one rank in comparison to physicality?
Physicality, I'd say number one, due to the intensity and the importance of the game as it pertains to our season.
Let's go back to the goal that opened the second half for Carson-Newman. That puts you down 2-0. You know, that's a lot of time to play, being down 2-0. What do you think? I looked at the guys out there on the field. Everybody was looking downfield toward the other goal. Everybody with their hands on their hips. It almost looked as though everybody thought this match was over. What was the mentality out there among the team?
Obviously, it's always terrible to get scored on. You know, you never put your head up after you get scored on. But I think our midfielders and our forwards worked hard enough to pull the game through for us.
This is a season where going into today's match, we'd been into four overtime matches this year. Among the four, we're still winless in overtime. We have a tie, but when we tied the match 2-2, I know there was a lot of time left. I personally didn't see another goal coming as quickly as it did, but were you guys thinking overtime again?
I'm sure it was going through our heads, but, you know, we're always looking to goal, trying to finish the game before overtime. I'm pretty sure we're all tired of going to overtime by now. And, you know, Mario just came out and put one in for us.
Gus, Saturday we've got the only undefeated team in the league when Queens comes to town. Obviously a huge task at hand. It's part of homecoming festivities here on the LMU campus. I know that you're going to probably be playing in front of the biggest crowd we've had here all year, and you got the biggest and strongest team that we've probably played this season in league play coming in. What's that going to be like over the next several days in preparation?
Well, first off, we got to rest tonight, make sure we get a good cool down, and keep hydrated for the game on Saturday because, obviously, like you said, they're undefeated, so they're going to be a tough team. But it's good that we have them at home. We'll have a good fan base out here to come watch us.
Gus, congratulations. Great match. Big part of this win here today, and enjoy it for the night and get back to business this weekend.
Thank you.
All right, Gus Rivera, your University Medical Clinic player of the match.
Folks, you know, I said you're going to have to wait to see. Is there any question as to who your University Medical Clinic offensive player of the match is? You got Mario Pinto comes in here. He's been in this position before. Mario, today we came out. Carson-Newman knew what you were capable of personally. It was a physical match from the very start, and I know that defensively they were making things tough for us in the first half.
Yeah, we knew that it was going to be a tough game, a physical game. We already been prepared ourselves to, like, get Carson-Newman over here. We knew that's going to be too much pressure. But, like, everyone could, like, work together whenever they were beating us 2-0 and could, like, get together and make, like, 1-2 and 3 and hold the game. We did great. We have to do it, like, every game on the season because, like, some games we start losing and then just keep going and go and then go overtime. And now we got the mentality to go forward and get the result. And
let's talk about, again, the 2-0 start for Carson-Newman. You go down 2-0. We've been in so many matches this year where we've outshot the opponent. We've outshot him in shots on goal. All of a sudden, same situation. We've outshot him. We've outshot him shots on goal. They're up 2-0. Again, I'll ask you the same thing that I asked Gus. What was the mentality out there? I mean, was it, all right, here we go again, or – did that make us even play even harder at that point?
Yeah, like we knew that they were beating us 1-0, and every they scored the second goal, like right on the beginning of the second half, we knew that they were going to be like harder than the other games. But this game, we got the right mentality to get everyone together, don't start to yelling each other with the other one, and everyone got together and played like great to score the goals and get the result.
Big match coming up on Saturday. Queens comes to town, obviously. For us, huge, huge ramifications of what the outcome will play. Nobody's been able to handle a loss in league play this year. We've got as legit a shot as anybody. We got them here at home. We're going to have a huge crowd at home. But it's going to be a tough task. What do we have to do to come out and take control of that match from the early minutes?
Well, we know that Queens has like a really quality group. They have like individual skills like we have. It's going to be like an open game, like we like to play, and let's like work this harder that we worked here today, and let's see what's going to happen and try to get the win again.
Mario, congratulations. Good luck on Saturday against the Royals.
Thank you.
Mario Pinto, your University Medical Clinic offensive player of the match. Let's take a brief 1-minute timeout. We'll be back with Helly O'Dana in Railsplitter wrap-up here on the LMU Sports Network.
Nestled at the foot of the Cumberland Gap, Lincoln Memorial University honors the vision and spirit of Abraham Lincoln. Lincoln's values are perfectly in sync with the modern educational experience at LMU. Our students find personal attention is a way of life and a way to success. If Lincoln Memorial University fits your vision of college, visit our website at lmunet.edu for more information.
The J. Frank White Academy is more than a high school. Your child will have room to grow in mind, body, and spirit. Small, safe learning environments, individualized learning plans, and cutting-edge technology. Every child deserves a quality education in a safe, nurturing environment.
Our college prep program teaches a love of learning, self-discipline, and service to others. The Academy is fully accredited by Advanced Ed. You have a choice at the J. Frank White Academy.
The Railsplitters improved to 5-4-1 on the year, 3-2-1 in South Atlantic Conference play with the come-from-behind victory today over Carson-Newman. Coach, I want to say that, you know, I said it during the match, it's great that we were able to come back, but you don't want to have to do it like that very often.
I have a feeling it's going to be like this the rest of the year. You know, it's another day in the office, but I kind of had flashbacks of last year's game against Lenoir Ryan. You were here, you know what I'm talking about, that it was a critical game. We had to win. This was a must win for both teams. And coming from behind and winning the fashion that we did last year, this particular game turned the season around and we made a run all the way to the conference championship. So maybe it's good omens and that will happen. But no doubt about it, this was a must win for both teams.
Coach, let's go back into the match. I mean, you know, Carson-Newman, we talked earlier in the week. You knew they were going to make it tough regardless of the outcome. It was going to be close. Nobody was going to get blown out. Early minutes of the match, I thought we tested the Carson-Newman keeper early, and he really held his composure nicely today under some fire.
No, without a doubt. But I, as you mentioned, we spoke earlier this week, and I had already said that Carson-Newman was the best team in the conference. No disrespect to anybody else, but at least on paper, you know, I mean, every game is a different story. But you're correct as far as what you said. But games, I don't know what it is. Games, LMU, Carson-Newman, it doesn't matter. Like today, we outshot them. Perhaps we had more chances to score, clear chances to score than they did. It's never an easy game. Never, never. Even when it was down to zero, I knew we'd make a run because it's the history of the rivalry.
When you're looking at this game and talking to your team later in the week or talking to future teams, will you refer back to this particular event in the fact that we went down 2-0, things didn't look good, and just the proof that you guys came back and won this one today in the way you did, it's never over until it's over.
Right, and I'll refer to the last game as well, Brevard. You know, we were not losing, but it was an incredible overcome of adversity, and that's what we did today. And at the end of the day, these are the little things you build on, you know. Obviously, if we had lost this game, I still would have found positives. But, man, there's a lot more.
You know, no surprise that we selected Mario Pinto as our offensive player of the match. But let's look at the defensive side. Actually, from the press box, we looked at you and threw it to you to make the call on this. And in reality, I mean, you had a bunch of guys you could have gone to. Nathaniel Johnson. You could have gone to Keegan Sanders, who made the start today. You could have gone to Harry Solomon. Gus Rivera is a guy who's played a role for us all year long. He gives a gutsy performance. And quite frankly, when he redshirted, I didn't give the guy credit that he was that hard-nosed of a player.
Well, the reason why I chose him today is because not only he and the rest of the defense play very well, but he had the toughest matchup because the freshman of the year from last year, number 8, for Carson-Newman, and you made allusion or you made mention of it, taller, faster possibly, stronger, and Gus got stuck in and battled through. And I don't know, I need to kind of look back in the footage. I think he won more balls against that guy than the other way around. So he earned it today, but you called it. The whole defense had to work so hard. And sometimes people forget the defense is not only the back, it's also the defensive mids. So like you mentioned, Keegan and Yuri deserve a lot of credit as well.
We don't select a surprising player of the match or anything like that, but if I had to give that award today, I would have to look back on that and say that you got some great minutes from Bryson Lynn.
Without a doubt. You know, he's a tiny little dude, and when he gets in and he jumps, I hope somebody picked on a picture. He's got hops, and that's he's got to have it because he's so much shorter than anybody else. But like you see in basketball, sometimes you have a tiny point guard and people think that it's a liability. But because of quickness and smarts that doesn't get exposed, that's the way Bryson plays. It never becomes a liability. So we're confident to put him in whenever we need.
All right, Saturday's going to come up quick. The Royals are going to come to town. First time they've been here on the LMU Soccer Complex field. Only undefeated team in the league. It's going to be an uphill battle. We know that there are no easy matches in the South Atlantic Conference. We have them here at home, but as many would look at that as an advantage, when you're playing a team like Queens, it's very little advantage.
Without a doubt, at least I'd rather play them here. Last year we played there. It wasn't conference yet. It was just a coincidence and very tough place to play. You know, turf. Big feud and a worn out turf, and I understand they're getting a new stadium next year, but the point is it's a different look than any other game. So hopefully our look is going to be different for them. Hopefully they'll give us a little edge over. But as Mario had mentioned, they have a lot of quality. They play a lot like us. So it should be, I encourage people to come and watch. It should be an incredibly well played game. I'll compare with our game with Coker, which was not here. So people might not have seen it, but it was one of the best games. You know, even officials coming off the field would mention that was a pleasure, you know.
Well, Coach, congratulations. Big win today, an exciting win, at least for the last 30 minutes of the match, 31 minutes, and I know that you're going to enjoy it for a little bit, but it'll be right back to the grind tomorrow. Royals are going to come in. They're going to be hungry, and it's going to be an uphill battle, but we wish you the best of luck and looking forward to Saturday's matchup.
Thank you so much.
All right, the Railsplitters win it here this afternoon over the Eagles of Carson-Newman. Folks, if you like Lincoln Memorial University Athletics, without a doubt, you know when LMU beats Carson-Newman, that's one that you're going to enjoy for a long, long time. There'll be stories about this one for years to come. most of the ones will be told by the players, but fans here as well that are going to relive this one for a long, long time. We've had a lot of help today on the cameras and on the crew. We appreciate everybody's hard work and effort. And for the life of me, I don't remember everybody's names that have worked today. Tony Spinoza started out with camera on this second broadcast for us. Adam Plyler came in. I think this is Matt down here. Matt's on the camera, and I don't recall his last name. Matt Rushing. Okay. Adam? Crawford. Okay. All right. We got to get those guys in there, too. Also, your technical director, Adam Haley. We've both been here for a long time this afternoon. So, again, production of Sigma Communications and part of the LMU Sports Network. Thanks to our executive producer, Tony Spinoza, for wearing dual hats today, coming in and filling in for some camera work. 3-2, your final here. The Railsplitters win it in regulation. They'll be in action on Saturday at 3:30 when they host the Royals of Queen's University. Lady Railsplitters get the day started at 1 o'clock. For everybody behind the scenes of Lincoln Memorial University Soccer, I'm Rusty Peace from the LMU Sports Network. So long, everybody.